Scene 1408. Don't forget to like and subscribe.
Meet Mary, a surgical student enrolled in a prestigious medical school. She's a dedicated learner, always putting in her best effort. But guess what? On weekends, she's not just hitting the books. She's also practicing her suturing skills on turkeys at home. Talk about commitment. Mary's professor sees incredible potential in her. During one class, though, Mary's phone unexpectedly rings, causing a break in the lecture flow. After class, Mary rushes to apologize, but the professor seems more disappointed about her dozing off in class earlier. He shares an important lesson. Surgeons can't just apologize. They need to be on their A game all the time. Mary has a valid explanation. She was up late practicing the night before. However, the professor isn't fully convinced and reminds her to prioritize her studies. After some reassurance, the professor departs, and Mary vows not to repeat her slip-up. By the way, that phone call during class? It was from her cell phone service provider with not-so-great news. They were planning to cut off her service due to unpaid bills. Financially, things aren't smooth sailing for Mary, but she maintains a cheerful facade when talking to her grandmother. Despite the challenges, Mary's determination leads her to a surprising decision. She decides to seek employment at a nightclub. She reaches out to the club manager via email, which scores her an interview the very same night. Now, here's where it gets interesting. The club isn't just any club, it's a strip club, and the boss, Billy, welcomes her for the interview. As they chat, Billy briefly glances at Mary's resume before setting it aside. It turns out that he's far more intrigued by Mary's attractive appearance and pheromones than her qualifications on paper. Out of the blue, a guy rushes into the room, urgently informing Billy about the absence of one of their team members. In a hurry, Billy turns to Mary and asks her to wait. After a short while, Billy returns, accompanied by a seriously injured man. Here's the twist. Billy offers Mary $5,000 to perform surgery on the injured man. But there's a condition. She must not ask any questions. Despite lacking a medical license, Mary finds herself in a tough spot. She's cash-strapped but determined. She accepts the offer, driven by her circumstances and the adrenaline that courses through her veins. The injured man's condition proves to be far more critical than Mary had initially anticipated. Nevertheless, equipped with only basic surgical tools and a heap of determination, Mary takes on the challenge. The surgery unfolds beautifully under her skilled hands. As the procedure concludes, she takes the money and makes a hasty retreat back home. It's her very first experience handling such a high-stakes surgery, and the weight of it all leaves her feeling jittery and apprehensive. In a vulnerable moment, she seeks solace in tears within the confines of her bathroom. Anxious about potential repercussions, she clings to a baseball bat before finally succumbing to sleep. Morning arrives and Mary's phone rings. On the other end is an unfamiliar woman who addresses her as doctor. Fearing a connection to the club and its murky dealings, Mary's heart races, prompting her to abruptly end the call. Just then, another call comes through, this time from her part-time job boss at the restaurant. He shares troubling news. The restaurant has been locked due to rental payment issues, which means Mary's income will take a hit, making life even tougher. Despite the setbacks, Mary's resilience shines through. Though disheartened, she channels her emotions into practicing suturing skills at home. Just as Mary immerses herself in her practice, the doorbell rings, signaling the arrival of her delivery. With the delivery courier at the door, Mary quickly shares a secret code for entry and invites her inside. Glancing at herself in the mirror, she spots blood stains on her apron. In response, she heads to the kitchen to remove the apron. But then, an unexpected event unfolds. Someone slips into the room. Mary swiftly turns, realizing the door is ajar. Standing there is a strange woman with a unique Betty Boop-esque appearance. This is Beatrice, the caller from earlier. In an attempt to ease Mary's anxiety and allow her to speak, Beatrice offers Mary $200 in cash. As an icebreaker, she reveals that she has undergone 14 surgeries to achieve her distinctive appearance. Today, her purpose is to ask Mary for a favor, performing a special surgery for a friend. Beatrice discovered Mary's resume through Billy, and she's impressed by her capabilities. She's willing to pay Mary a hefty sum of $10,000 for the task. However, Mary declines, asserting that she won't repeat the actions of the previous night. Understanding Mary's stance, Beatrice doesn't push her further. Instead, she proposes an enticing alternative, even if Mary hasn't fully decided yet. Showing up tomorrow will earn her $2,000. The prospect of such easy money lingers in Mary's mind, tempting her. As the next evening arrives, Mary follows through and arrives at a veterinary clinic. There, Beatrice is waiting, ready to hand over a significant sum of $12,000. She lays out the instructions, requesting that Mary adhere to the patient's guidance. Stepping into the next room, Mary comes face to face with Beatrice's friend, who shares a striking resemblance to Beatrice herself. This friend has an unusual aspiration, to resemble a genderless human doll. The request is quite bewildering for Mary to digest. To ensure she's not misunderstanding, Mary double-checks with Beatrice. Once her understanding is confirmed, Mary cautiously agrees to undertake the surgery. The surgery progresses smoothly, meeting the expectations. When it's all wrapped up, Mary disposes of the surgical waste and offers post-surgery advice to Beatrice for her friend. She also emphasizes the importance of confidentiality, urging Beatrice not to disclose any personal details about her. With that, Mary hurries away. Upon reaching home, the weight of the experience hits her, causing her to feel physically ill and vomit, a visceral reaction to the shock of the procedure. In due course, Mary embarks on her residency at a medical institution. One day, on her way to work, she encounters a familiar figure, Beatrice. Beatrice expresses gratitude for the surgery, explaining that she refrained from calling in compliance with Mary's request. As a token of appreciation, Beatrice presents Mary with a gift. After a cordial exchange, Mary continues on her way to work. At day's end, Mary receives an unexpected invitation from her tutor to attend a party at his residence. This invitation catches her off guard, as she had presumed her tutor didn't hold a favorable opinion of her. Mary decides to attend the event, wearing the dress that Beatrice had gifted her. At the party, her tutor engages in conversation with her, exhibiting a much gentler demeanor than usual. Amid their talk, her tutor offers Mary a glass of wine. Mary takes a sip of the wine without hesitation. However, after just one sip, an unexpected dizziness washes over her, swiftly plunging her into unconsciousness. To her horror, her encounter with the professor takes a nightmarish turn as he reveals his true intentions. He guides Mary to a bedroom, where she falls victim to his humiliating advances. Worse yet, he captures the disgraceful event on camera. When Mary regains consciousness, she finds herself and the professor unclothed and entangled in a disconcerting scene. Overwhelmed by shock and disgust, Mary flees back home. Gazing at her medical textbooks, she reaches a drastic decision. A few days later, Mary makes an unconventional choice. She abandons her medical residency and recruits Billy for a drastic plan. Her target? The professor. Mary is determined to perform body modification surgery on him as revenge. In a chilling twist of fate, the once confident professor is now bound to an operating table, trembling with fear. What unfolds is a macabre series of procedures, including tongue splitting, teeth filing, hormone-based modifications, and amputation. The agonizing process stretches on for a grueling 14 hours. This gruesome act serves as the catalyst for Mary's transformation into an adept underground plastic surgeon. Now, with the help of Billy and his associates, Mary's surgical skills cater to a clandestine clientele. They handle the task of bringing in potential clients and managing those that Mary chooses not to accept. Mary immerses herself in her surgical work, carving out a reputation for herself through her remarkable skills. Her expertise becomes renowned, drawing admiration from all quarters. Then, an unexpected encounter unfolds. A police officer approaches Mary. He's probing the mysterious disappearance of the professor, piecing together unsettling facts about him. Armed with a list of individuals who might hold grudges against the professor, the officer seeks any insights Mary may offer. In response, Mary adopts an air of innocence. She claims to have just heard about the situation and explains that the professor was rather strict with her. She suggests that their interactions might be perceived as strained due to his demanding demeanor, though she asserts that harboring ill feelings towards him wouldn't be justified. The officer provides his contact information, urging Mary to reach out if she comes across any relevant information. However, Mary doesn't take the officer's inquiry seriously. In her mind, she dismisses the notion of assisting with the investigation, feeling confident that her secrets are well hidden. Under the cover of night, Mary heads to the club to rendezvous with Beatrice and Billy. However, a sense of unease gnaws at her, fueled by the possibility that the investigating police officer might have uncovered information from the professor's colleagues present at the gathering. As the evening progresses, Mary's apprehension grows. When Beatrice finishes her performance, she and Mary leave the club together. Before parting ways, Beatrice bestows yet another gift upon Mary. The surgery for Beatrice's friend has garnered significant attention online, drawing the interest of two potential clients willing to pay generously for their own transformative surgeries. This time, the spotlight falls on twin sisters, who harbor an unconventional desire. They wish to trade their arms and undergo modifications to acquire a demon-like appearance. The prospect of significant financial gain looms, opening up new opportunities for Mary's underground surgical talents. Billy arranges for an assistant to help Mary with the simultaneous surgeries, ensuring everything goes smoothly. The procedures for the twin sisters yield remarkable success, showcasing Mary's exceptional surgical talents. As Mary revels in her accomplishment, her thoughts drift to the imprisoned professor. She ventures into the room where he's held captive, a camera in hand to document her victory. The gruesome sight of the professor, now legless and armless, with his ability to speak taken from him, fuels a sense of triumph within Mary. She taunts him, emphasizing that she's evolved into not just a top-notch surgeon, but one who can afford to embrace her mistakes as well. Mary proudly showcases her achievements in front of her former tormentor. In an unexpected turn, Mary is blindsided by a security guard who knocks her to the ground, attempting to free the professor. Mary swiftly retaliates, incapacitating the security guard. Meanwhile, Billy seizes an opportunity to extract revenge on the professor's colleague. During this violent encounter, he receives a call from Mary, signaling a pivotal moment in their grim operation. Unable to answer the phone himself due to his ongoing tasks, Billy delegates the responsibility to one of his associates, a tough-looking man with long hair. Meanwhile, Mary is grappling with the aftermath of her intense actions, feeling overwhelmed and in a state of shock. In the midst of her daze, the long-haired tough guy arrives. He perceives Mary's distress and decides to share his own past experience to offer comfort. He recounts a painful incident from his life. A few years ago, someone invaded his mother's home and subjected her to a brutal attack. She suffered severe injuries, and he describes how he deliberately kicked her phone away to prevent her from seeking help. His mother was discovered only 3 days later and had to endure 4 months of hospitalization. Reflecting on the past, he confides that if he had known someone like Mary at the time, he would have asked her to suture the attacker. He urges Mary not to undervalue her actions and advises that if she ensures that those she targets deserve it, guilt is unwarranted. His words resonate with Mary, offering her a sense of clarity and acceptance regarding her actions. The next morning, the twins awaken, demonstrating their satisfaction with the surgery's success by presenting Mary with a substantial sum of money. Mary's reputation as an underground plastic surgeon of notoriety spreads rapidly, attracting a growing number of clients seeking her unique modification surgeries. On a certain day, just as she's wrapping up an appointment, she receives a call from the police officer. In haste, she tidies up the operating room, only to realize that the officer has already arrived at the gate. Nervously suspecting that he might be onto her activities, she discreetly spikes his water with a drug. The officer discloses that he's uncovered incriminating tapes showcasing the professor's sexual assaults on girls. While Mary herself isn't in the footage, the officer perceives her as a potential victim. He comes to offer assistance if she requires it. Seizing an opportunity, Mary switches out his drink with another laced with the same drug. The officer genuinely wants to prevent Mary's life from spiraling downward, yet seeing her reluctance to discuss the matter, he respects her boundaries and departs. As the officer leaves, Mary notices a missed call on her phone. Returning the call, she receives the devastating news of her grandmother's passing. With her sole family member gone and lacking friends, Mary's only recourse is to turn to Billy. However, when she arrives at the club, she discovers Billy in a compromising situation with one of the new girls. Hastily removing the girl upon seeing Mary, Billy faces her inquiry about the tape's removal. Billy, though having taken Mary's tapes, refrains from admitting to it, and both he and Mary remain silent about the situation. There's an unspoken understanding between them, shrouded in the air of secrecy. Mary doesn't engage in much conversation with him, leaving the room abruptly. To their mutual surprise, Mary's emotional turmoil culminates in an unexpected confrontation with the girl in the restroom. Armed with surgical tools, Mary is on the verge of an extreme act before she spots a surveillance camera, prompting her to abandon her plan. Later that night, Mary and Billy have a crucial meeting at the club. Mary is determined to express her true feelings, but Billy surprises her by sharing that he hasn't heard from Beatrice in a considerable amount of time. Amid the ongoing chaos, he reveals his yearning for a change in his life's pace. With genuine sincerity, he proposes a proposition, an invitation for Mary to travel alongside him. Faced with this proposition, Mary doesn't offer an immediate answer, explaining that she requires time for contemplation. Little does Mary know, this conversation would mark the final exchange between her and Billy as their paths take an unexpected turn. In a shocking twist of events, the moment Mary arrives home, she receives a call from Beatrice. However, the call isn't one of good news. Beatrice reveals she's been gravely injured by her friend's unhinged husband, who went on to kill her friend as well. Through a harrowing ordeal, Beatrice was coerced into revealing Mary's address. Before Mary can fully comprehend the situation, she is viciously stabbed from behind. Summoning her strength, Mary manages to wrest control of the weapon from her attacker and ultimately kills him in self-defense. Despite her critical condition, she musters every ounce of her energy to reach the operating room and attempt to suture her own wound. An experienced surgeon who has performed numerous surgeries, Mary's skill set falls short in this dire moment. Tragically, she can't save her own life, succumbing to her injuries. Later, when the police arrive, they discover Mary's lifeless body. As they investigate further, they stumble upon the professor's lifeless form within the house, unfolding the horrifying tale that has transpired.